Hi everyone, welcome back to Linda Libra Loca. Today I want to talk about a topic that I get asked quite a lot in the comments, which are the 5 ingredients that I think everybody should have in an anti-aging skincare routine. If you're new here, hi, welcome. My name's Anne. I'm a doctor and a beauty lover, and I'm passionate about sharing beauty tips and tricks for people with more mature skin. So if you're into that, please take a second and subscribe. The first ingredient, and one that really everybody needs, is a form of sunscreen. I don't care which kind of sunscreen you prefer, just make sure that you apply it every day, that it offers broad spectrum protection, so protection against UVA and UVB, and that the protection factor is high enough. If you don't use sunscreen, you can basically skip any other anti-aging ingredient as well, because nothing will reverse the damage the sun does to your skin. And yes, even the damage done on a cloudy day, even the damage done if you spend your days inside next to a window, because UVA, it penetrates to clouds, it penetrates to the windows, it is everywhere, and it gives you wrinkles, saggy skin, and fine lines. So the first ingredient from an early age, sunscreen. The second ingredient, and again one that I recommend you implement into your routine from a very early age, is hyaluronic acid. And by the way, if you're wondering when is the right time to incorporate which ingredient into your routine, I did a whole video on that topic that I'm going to link in the cards and down in the description box. Hyaluronic acid is a humectant, and humectants attract moisture to the skin, water to the skin, and make the skin appear plump, smooth out fine lines, and are very important for an intact skin barrier. So it's not only about the looks, but it's about how your skin feels, and it's about how good your skin can defend itself. Of course, there are other humectants, it's not only hyaluronic acid, you can use glycerin or something like that, but make sure you have a strong humectant in your routine. The third one, and this is where we get a little more specific, is antioxidants. Preferably vitamin C. Why? Because vitamin C is one of the best researched antioxidants, and it offers a variety of other benefits other than catching free radicals and preventing further damage. It does improve collagen production, it helps with brightening dark spots that you get from UV exposure or in form of post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation. If you don't get along with the vitamin C because it irritates your skin and you don't want to try a different kind of vitamin C, there's a ton of them out there. And I'm going to make an overview video soonish, I hope. But make sure you have a vitamin C or another kind of antioxidant like Q10, because it's really important to get these free radicals that develop in your skin and to prevent signs of aging and skin damage before it appears. The fourth ingredient I think everybody should at least try to incorporate into their routine is a kind of retinol. Why? Because retinol is one of the very few ingredients that actually has a proven benefit on increasing cell turnover and increasing collagen production. There are so many plant extracts out there that claim to do all that, but the scientific studies behind them are scarce at best or non-existent. The only exception is retinol. It has proven its worth. Yes, it's kind of a tricky one. Yes, there is a ton of different retinoids out there, but that's the beauty of it. There is one that you are able to tolerate. Maybe prescription strength, because you build up your skin's strength. May it be bakuchiol, and again I have a video on that one, which claims to be much gentler but as effective. There is a kind of retinol that you can use, and once you pass 30-35, I think you should consider adding it into your routine. The fifth and final one, and this is probably the most controversial one, because the other four, yeah, every derm will tell you that. The fifth one is peptide, and hear me out on that. Yes, I know that research on peptides is conflicting, and I know that there needs to be much more research before we can say for sure that they work. But what we can say for sure right now is that they do no harm. And with brands like the Inculis and The Ordinary offering peptide solutions for a very, very affordable price, I don't think there's any reason not to incorporate them into your routine. In the worst case, you have wasted €9 in 3 months. In the best possible case, you have something that will prove its anti-aging worth in the time to come. As always, I will leave some product recommendations down in the description box, but these are just products that I have tried and like, feel free to use whatever you come across and what works for your skin. I'm going to link a few other videos on the screen now that I think you might enjoy. And again, don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any further videos. And I'm going to see you all very soon in the next one. Bye!